All right, what's up, my beautiful people? I have a Robinhood clip. I'm going to go over that account and talk about a lesson. Even though it's the Robinhood account, I think this could be applied to everybody, and it's talking about when to take losses. So we talked about this and even some stuff on the market today, and I even talked about what the stock market did, and I'm going to show you that here, but then I'm going to cut to the Robinhood clip. Before though, make sure you guys are all subscribed to the live streaming channel. Again, we're doing it every single trading day. Open, no close. Well, I got off, pretty much I get around an hour or two before market. It depends. You know, people have to go to work today. They kind of fell off, but you guys just go to any of the recent videos. Oh, this one, I think I put it down a lot more. Wait, where is it? Uh-oh. Yeah, live trading channel. There you go. See, I see how some of you guys get confused. It's also on the main channel here, as you guys see. Going back to the main channel, you go click here. So it's all looped. I hope to see you guys there. So yeah, now let me show you guys what I was referring to in the video was kind of what was happening here with the S&P 500. And the fact is that the last couple days, the market has been moving, but where have the gains been coming from? You know, even since Thursday, it was a gap down and then the market came up. You could have made money on calls, but then again, you're going back to break even from the day before. The market gaps up. And this was a 300-400 point day, but a majority of the gains just happened right here. And today we gapped down and then went up, and some of the options are there. But if you go watch the stream, the trades aren't really there, and this isn't ideal for options volatility and options pricing. So I wanted you guys to see that, and I hope it helped. But yeah. Let me know also too, I'm going to make a few videos today. If you guys have questions, I want to talk about what's going on with the trade talks, what's going on with China and some of the other news. So if you have anything you guys want me to touch on, or if you have any information that would be cool or that you think I haven't seen so far, please put it below and I'd love to hear from you guys. So hope you enjoy this. All right, boys. So day four of the Robinhood account. And would you look at that? We're only 15 bucks above where I started. And there's a lot to learn from this. I think this is my biggest lesson, and it's identified a flaw in the strategy or something I want to change. So I want to hear your guys' thoughts on it, but I want to just show you guys about it and talk about it. And one, it's changing the strategy, or at least, you know, what I'm trying to show you is finding my mistakes. You know, it's finding where we have gotten the biggest killer. And I'll show you guys once I get to the weekly chart of the account. But then the next thing is identifying trading. Now, I know a lot of you guys have been rushing into trades. We talked about this a lot on stream today because today was boring. And the last 2 days, it brought up something very, very important where the market has moved. You know, we're still seeing market moves, but you're getting gap ups and the moves throughout the day is very slow. It's kind of happening where you got to put your trades in. And then really, it's a great swing trading environment, not necessarily day trading. There is some trades that were made, but it's too risky in the sense of I'm being cautious. And now remember, I'm trying to treat this account like a big account, and I didn't. I failed. I failed that with the losses because, and that's what's making me re-identify and saying, what do we do here and how do we do it? But take a look. Here's the weekly chart. You know, this is just day four or day five of the account. And as you see, we went from 250 quickly to 290. How do I do? Wait, maybe 1 month here, right? So you guys see, so February 12th, so it's been like 6 days, but then we had the weekend, went up 295, 304, 289, and then back to 269. So I'm still up, but I love the weekly chart because it shows here as we're going through February 14th, then it comes into here. But now look at this drop off today. This is going to show you guys something about options. Once you reach a certain point in with implied volatility, the contract prices, it just falls off a cliff. And I'm going to show you. I haven't made any new trades. Maybe I should have bought some crypto. Some people were asking me about that. Who knows? We might use it. We might not. But it's the same plays. It's the Baba put, the CGC call, and the Cron call. Now, Cron is going to have earnings. So this one's still kind of in play, but it got killed. And now take a look. And this is what I realized. Look at today's return. I lost 10 bucks today. I didn't pay attention to it. CGC, $5. There, so that's 15 bucks total. Baba, another $9. That's another $24. So I fell off the cliff. Where was it right here? This, what was the account at? Pretty much 280. If I cut those losses I was already down with, it capitulated after that. And this is capitulation. If you guys aren't familiar, it's just like, okay, and that was the strategy. I kind of set a strategy of capitulation where I'm kind of scratching my head because the rule I set in place for this strategy was that I was just going to hold them. I don't want to take a loss. But now that came in from selling premium, but I'm an idiot because I'm buying contracts. So it worked against me now. But this brings up the question for a lot of you guys, when do you take profits or when do you cut losses? So in this case, I'm thinking, because I'm noticing something, total gain 65% after that, total gain here 87%, and then total gain loss 43%. So I should cut this BABA in a little bit. I should hold on because I think the new strategy, I might cut them at 50% if I'm playing these cheaper contracts that are out of the money. And I'm thinking now, if I'm taking quick at 5 or 10, if I'm allowing myself to lose 100%, it's putting me at a very, very big disadvantage. And that's what I'm sure how many of you guys have experienced this, because this is the number one cause of everything. I hit one good trade, two good trade, three good trade, four good trade, and then one streak of bad trades, or one trade really, you know, there's just two trades that I fucked up on. You know, the CGC, this one was about $14, $16, but these two, take a look, I spent $38 there and another 30 something bucks there. 32, that's 60, 70 bucks right there. That's stupid. That's foolish. And that's what I was talking about. And I said I was overexposed, but I justified holding it. So here's a mistake in that sense you guys are seeing. But now what made this all click for me was that not only, obviously, hindsight's 2020, you know, you take a loss, you learn everything. You're like, oh my God, it makes sense now. Yeah. But the big part about it was that if this was a $200,000 account, like, if I was already down, you know, if I'm losing 10 grand, 20 grand, you know, it would make sense to cut 50% or cut at 50% because I'm taking far out of the money option. So why do I say cut at 50%? Because after they hit that point, unless volatility or the stock moves a lot, the chances of it coming back up are very low. However, on the contrary, you know, BABA kind of was a little all over the place at the same time. It did come back up that one day, but then after that, it fell off a cliff. And again, it all has to do with the underlying asset. But I think that is going to be the policy I'm going to be making. And now another thing too, I saw an update, account summary. Here it is. The day trades. The day trades still exist. So it hasn't been the 3 or 4 trading days. So I'm going to monitor when these expire. But essentially, I thought it would be a shorter time for these to clear up, but it didn't. So nothing too crazy with that. But hopefully you guys are seeing, this should show you something about options, holding them, excuse me, and then also the options that are further out of the money. So now what I'm trying to develop here and what we really need to think about is when to take profits. And I think it's going to be coming at 50% or take losses, excuse me. We have an idea to take profits, but now managing these losses is going to be key with the small account. But usually, and this is where I'm balancing, because I should take 50% loss if the account is levered high. And what I mean by this, you know, I had 70 bucks in there. I had $86 out of 300 bucks, almost 30% of the account played. And again, that's like 80,000 of 300,000. That's a lot. And if it has, you know, you see, this is the risk of options, and this is what you gotta do. It's always good when the going's good. But once you get in that, in this mode, this is where you start to get killed. And it's not, don't think it's gonna bounce as much as it will. And that's why I'm like, oh, I have to re-identify it. And that's something too, I'm not taking as many trades now, but I didn't even take a trade Friday because I was holding these when they were holding some of the value, but you saw it went against me. So the key here is gonna be taking the losses. And I think if I have more than 30% of the account, I have to cut at 50%. However, I wanna stick to my normal strategy of not cutting it, but that's only gonna apply if I'm in like $13 options like the CGC. And that was my mistake for over trading. You know, I think at the end of the day, this is just purely over trading, and that's what we got out of it. So hopefully you guys are learning. You're seeing it's, you know, this is difficult, but not really. And as you guys see, one thing, I'm okay with taking the loss, but I'm not okay with losing. And what I mean by that, this is chess, you know, just because now I'm down. And this is something, my biggest lesson for you guys here, just because I'm down, I'm not going to force it. I'm not going to force a trade until my setup gets there, until I see something like the other trades. Because when I did hit the winning trades, I hit them. You know, all of these trades, except for, I was up on them. Every single trade, I was up on them at one point, and I didn't take the profit. Cron, I got greedy. CGC, I got greedy. BABA, I got greedy. You know, the biggest lesson of all of this, I totally just blanked on what I was going to say, but not to over leverage yourself. So I'm going to leave it there. Oh, and not trading. What am I saying? Not to over leverage yourself, but don't force the trades.
you guys are going to win. Wait till you get the best trade. And that's what I've been doing. I've been waiting for the best trade, and I haven't been seeing them the last couple days. I'm looking around, but until I get a good catalyst, and there's nothing wrong with that, because I'd rather wait and get the better trade and make my money back than, you know, oh, I'm down here. I'm posting the videos. You know, I showed a random person my YouTube channel. They're like, dude, you lost 10% of your account. Like, you know, people are like, oh, are you going to make a trade in the chat? And I've talked about this with, you know, pressure and all that. And I'm sure you guys don't have, you know, people looking at you and commenting and, yeah, you suck, Josh. Oh, you're good. Or what, you know, but I'm sure a lot of you guys put this same pressure on yourself where you're like, I need to make a trade. I need to make money. I'm down now. That's not how it works. Again, this is a game of chess. Take your loss. Take what it is. And, you know, if there was a good trade, I'd strike at it. You know, I would have taken it. You guys see, you know, I want the money, but I want a better trade even more. And that is the goal, because when we hit the trades, we're making money. And I broke the rule. We see the losses. And now I'm seeing a way to now balance it. And this is what it's about. It's about being dynamic with your trading and adjusting. You know, I'm not trying to be too rigid, but that I could also foresee that as being a problem, because I don't want to keep switching up the strategy. And hopefully you guys see I'm not trying to make drastic changes, but I am trying to make sure I don't get caught up making dumb mistakes or something avoidable, especially if the data and the trades are showing me something. So I'll leave it there. I love you guys. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure I see you on stream tomorrow morning. I love you. Goodbye.